Proverbs 20 says that a person's steps are from the Lord. And how can we understand our own way? I think it's a great passage to reflect on as we start talking about the song that I want to share with you tonight. It's called I Wonder as I Wander. And it was a song written by John Jacob Niles. John Jacob Niles was just really passionate about folk music. He as from a young child all the way up through, he just really enjoyed folk music and found himself learning and collecting the tunes everywhere that he went. Well, as John came up through and he ended up having a couple of different jobs and then went into the service and served in World War I. Everywhere he went, he would collect folk songs. And while he was serving during World War I, he would ask his fellow soldiers over and over again, what were the folk songs they knew? And he would write them down. He came back with a book of folk songs. That really became his life's passion. And so after the war, he came back and he moved back to Kentucky. And from there in his hometown, he would then travel out to other areas. And one time he was traveling through North Carolina and he came upon this little village, and it seemed like the village had been, or the town had been, untouched by time in some respects. They're really isolated from the things that were going on in the rest of the world, but it was around the holidays. There was snow on the ground and kids were running through the street and then stopping at store windows and looking in to see what was in the store, what they might want for Christmas or what have you. And so John Jacob found himself walking around the street, really just enjoying the humble setting and the peace and the quiet. And his attention was drawn to a little girl on a bench. And that little girl was singing a song. And it got John's attention because it sounded like a folk song. So he edged over closer and he was listening. And when she finished, he sat down next to her and he said, "Little girl, would you mind singing that again for me? I'd like to write down that song and learn it from you." And of course, the song she was singing was I Wonder as I Wander. That song stuck in his mind and really haunted him for years. He just because it was such an engaging and meaningful song, and he wondered where it came from. And John would spend the rest of his life until he died in 1980 trying to figure out where that song had come from. He never found the small girl again. He never was able to trace down where she had come from or where her mother, her grandmother, had learned that song. But we have that song today because John was going around and cataloging it. And he was willing to be in a place where there was that moment where he met this little girl and was able to hear that song. Now, you could say that that's coincidence, it was chance. But I want to suggest to you, John's passion led him to a place where he could experience that moment. What if that was a divine moment? What if that was a moment that God had planned for John to experience? And what if John had said, "I really don't feel like going," or "I'm not going to travel today"? Would that girl have been there the next time if he'd gone through that city at a different day or a different time? We don't know. All we know is that he chose to go there, was willing to go there, and he had this experience. I want to suggest to you, in line with Proverbs 20, God has plans for all of our steps. He knows where we're going to be tomorrow and the next day. And he has already planned out things for us to be doing that are some of it's to accomplish things that he's planned that are good for others. Some is good for us. Some of it has nothing to do with us at all. But it's not going to happen if we're not willing to go there. Ephesians 2:10 says that we're his workmanship, created in Christ Jesus to do good works that he's prepared in advance for us to do. I think that echoes what we hear in Proverbs 20. You know, the rest of Proverbs 20 goes on to say, it's a snare to make a rash decision and then later have to consider our vows. We have a lot of expectations. We have a lot of things we'd like to do. And sometimes the expectations we have and the things we'd really like to do get in the way of simply being available and going where the Holy Spirit might be leading us, going where God may lead us. I can't tell you the number of times where I've felt like I needed to be somewhere, or I was driving somewhere and I felt like I needed to just take a moment and detour off. And it ends up being an encounter with a person who either needed encouragement or we end up talking about something meaningful in their life. So with the song, I Wonder as I Wander, I just want to encourage you and challenge you this Christmas season. Think about John Jacob's experience. Listen to the song and be able to sit quietly and think to yourself, what have I resisted doing? Where have I resisted going? Where might God want me to be this holiday season, even moment to moment? How do I make my going out, even if it's Christmas shopping or getting groceries or going to work, how do I make myself available so I'm in those places that the Holy Spirit has led me to, so that I can encounter and experience something of God that maybe He's prepared for me, or I can help someone else encounter God in a moment that He's prepared for them?